just think a little bit. Don't make the mistake thinking old-fashioned. Times have changed from yesterday. No longer will those old double standards be accepted by the women of today. So when you think you're fooling her, she just might be fooling you. Remember, if you can do it, she can too. Because a woman needs love just like you do. Don't kid yourself into thinking that she don't. Cause she can fool around just like you do. Unless you give her all the love she wants. When her eyes are begging for affection, don't put it off and don't make her wait. No, don't try to give her that worn out excuse about being tired or working late. I tell you, one day you'll come home early from work, open up the door and get your feelings hurt. Because she needs it, yeah. Woman's got to have it, just like you. And if you're smart, yeah, you better stop fooling around, hey, hey. Oh, cause she will too.
Then, of course, there's my mischievous favorite, obviously, just a little bit, just a little bit. I told you this wine thing, we just, the wine, stir it in the glass, sip a little bit, spit it out. I don't know about spitting me out, what do you think? I don't like the way that sounds. Drink it, then get a little bit of different race, sip that in, just savor the flavor, you know, just like grapes. I always like the story. I'm just the average guy. You know what you guys do. Fool around, little on the side. Never thought it would amount to much. Never met a girl whose love was so tough. Now who'd have thought a one-night stand could turn into such a hot romance? But when she did it to me, I slipped and fell in love. I'm in love. Because you know, every girl's think this stuff is hot. So you gotta slip and fall. The other woman thinks it's so much better than the other one. The me one. That's how it's been, I guess. Ooh. Now I knew the rules of the game. Supposed to hit it once, break it away clean. Now you know if you go back for more, that's when the shits get started. Hit it once, you won't get in trouble. Nobody gets caught breaking the law once. Hit it once, break away clean.
Should've never gone back, I know. But I had to have just a little bit. My friends laugh, but that's alright. I may be a fool, but I know what I like. Now I hate to have to cheat, but it feels better when I sneak. Oh, I'm in love. With the other woman, my life is fine till she blew my mind. Tell me, any else y'all out there ever fell in love with someone else's woman or someone else's man? I'm playing the guitar soft so I can hear the truth. Can't hear you.
Okay, we got just enough time. We're out of time, but we have to hit that song, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so he was asking about that song. So what happened is, what happened with that song is the music was easy because the director came to me and says, I want some bar band music. So to me, it sounded like Green Onions. Like, okay, you want those same, like, you like Clive Davis, you just want those three happy clothing. You know, I can sing your eight banger song. So that wasn't a bit hard. Then he says, I want this tempo. And he had this disco kind of tempo. So that was easy. So, you know, as a musician, you say, okay, his director wants this tempo. Put your stopwatch on. Okay. Straight dance tempo at the time. Whatever the dance tempo was, you clock the dance tempo. You got the tempo. He's already told you kind of what chords he wants. He doesn't know what he's saying, but he plays you a bunch of songs. And they all have the same chords. And say, okay, he wants those bar blues chords. You know, I'm doing it. You know, just regular bar blues chords. Yeah, a little saxophone. So you get the music down. I'm thinking, okay, I got that part. But the hard part, he says, is I want the words Ghostbusters in the song. I was like, wait a minute, I knew it was too easy to get this money. I knew it was going to be too easy, right? I had my hand just on the money, and I was like, oh, I can't get it. So I had 2 days to do this, and I was really running out of time. I kid you not. I think it was like a spiritual moment. I had all the music done. It was only a minute and a half of music anyway. I mean, we didn't have no record. It was just going to be the library scene of the film. So we had a minute and a half of music. And I had zero words. I had no idea how I was going to say this Ghostbusters. And it was the deal killer. You don't say the word Ghostbusters in the music, that ain't going to happen. And I was falling asleep on the couch. The messenger was going to show up at 9 a.m. And I think it was like 4 in the morning. And I was dead tired of sleep. I had been up all the time. But you know, it's a nice thing when you're sleeping, you're like half awake, half asleep. And there's a part in the movie where the Ghostbusters had the backpacks on. They lined up. And they got the phone number underneath it. Well, you know, I think they borrowed that from a commercial. Because late at night, I was watching my TV, and on comes this Roto-Rooter commercial. And the Roto-Rooter guys got their thing, they get ready to attack, and they stand with the packs, and be sleepy. And the phone number came out, call Roto-Rooter, wash your troubles down here. Roto-Rooter, who do you call? Call Roto-Rooter, wash your troubles down here. Just like the ones in the movie to me. Now I know exactly what to do, you know. So I woke up like really early in the morning. I woke up right then and there, actually. I just couldn't get nobody else to wake up. Now I needed that crowd to yell. I knew what had to happen. What occurred to me at 5 in the morning was for me not to sing Ghostbusters ever. I never say that word in the song. I just go, who are you going to call? So I'm pitching, right? But then I needed a crowd of girls to sing, you know, and guys, I need that crowd. It just so happened I was dating this girl who was a high school girl at the time. Don't spend too much time on that. Just go with me with the story. We're running out of time. I'll tell you a story. So, she was 18. I called her up. She got the rest of her high school girl. I was only 20-something, so just a second. She's the age my wife is, difference of now, but you know, at the time it was, you know, I'm not going to explain that to you. I don't owe y'all no explanation. I'm just telling you how the song came out. So anyway, she got some high school kids to come right before they went to class at 8 in the morning. It was like 7 in the morning. And I said, all y'all got to do is wait till I go, who y'all call? Just go, Ghostbusters! So they had that high voice and that energy. And they had that energy. I think if we had some like 28 years old, it would have been the same energy. So they had that energy. Then they left, and around about 7:30, I started putting the leads down, you know. And I just made up as I went along, because the messenger was, by that time, was waiting at the door. And it sort of went like, I just made up some words as it went along, like, if something strange in your neighborhood, who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
If it's something weird and it don't look good, tell me who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
Then I went, that was my John Williams section with the heart. If you see a face running through your head, tell me who can you call?
Ghostbusters.
An invisible man sleeping in your bed. Who can you call?
Ghostbusters.
In keeping with Ray Parker Jr. style, we have to have the invisible man in the bed. That goes back to where I come from. You know, so, ghost has to have sex. But because it's a kid's movie, the kids can't know the ghost is having sex. I mean, it's just got to be over their head so they don't get it. That way you can play it on top for the radio, you know. So when you say, I'm afraid of no ghosts. I hear it likes the girls. I'm afraid of no ghosts. You know, it goes right over it, you know. Buster makes me feel good. And my son said, what does that mean, Dad? Buster making you feel good. Busting ghosts. Ghost busting. Bust. Busting ghosts. I can't believe this crowd. You guys are thinking. Busting ghosts. Yes. If you've had a dose of a freaky ghost, baby, you better call. And my son said, what does it mean if you've had a dose, Dad? Freaky ghosts. I said, well, don't worry about this. It'll come. Song last night. So that's how that song came about. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you so much.